Hello there and welcome! Let's see how to put effects and transitions with PowerDirector 12. In case you find mistakes, leave us a feedback. Let's apply effects to our clips. When you select any clip, you have different buttons above the timeline that list the main features the software can do. These change according to the kind of clip you have selected. If you select audio clips, many buttons appear, for example the one to rule the keyframes or the edit audio button. You may need specific Cyberlink softwares to edit audio deeply. However, you can add some nice effects going on Power Tools. Power Tools settings window shows a list of advanced effects you can apply to your clip. Choose the effect from the list on the left. A tick the effect is turned on. Untick it to turn it off. Use the options on the right to give the correct settings, so you can play audio in reverse or change the playing speed. This doesn't change the original pitch. Remember that you can always come back editing these effects, opening the Power Tool window through its related button. If you select a video clip, you have other buttons, apart from keyframes and so on. If you click on Power Tools, you can apply advanced effects as seen with the audio clip. You can play the video in reverse, change the video speed, or crop it. Very interesting is the 2D to 3D conversion to turn your video in 3D. To watch this, you may have to press the big 3D button below the preview. Remember to render 3D in the end if you use 3D content. Video clips have also the Fix Enhance button. This is used to edit and improve the aspect of the video. Fix section is auto, improving lightness and clarity and reducing video and audio noise. Enhance section is more manually. You can add your own levels of contrast and lightness, hue and saturation for the color, vibrance and sharpness. You can tick and untick to see the difference. Otherwise, tick in the bottom left corner and watch the preview. If you don't see this, you may need to enlarge the window. Click on keyframes to open the keyframe settings to change the effects in time. To know more about keyframes, watch the related video in our guide. Check out the color director as well. This has very nice presets you can apply to your video. Let's see the image clips. You can go to Power Tools again to convert in 3D and add other advanced effects. You can go to Fix Enhance here too. As seen with the video clip, adjust lightness, color and clarity the best way. Enhancements and Power Tools applied to a clip make an eye icon appear in a corner. If you hover it, you will have a general list of all the effects applied. Apart from the Fix Enhance and the Power Tool effects, you have other tools in the effect room, indicated through an FX icon. This lists all visual effects that can be applied to an image and video clips only. Simply select one and drag it on the clip interested. The orange eye will list these effects as well. All effects added through the effect room can be managed using the effect button that appears in the list above. In this way you can open the effect settings window. On the left you have the full list of the effects added. Select an effect to edit it through the options on the right. tick or untick to turn it on or off. Use the minus button to remove the selected effect from the list definitely. Some of these effect templates are fixed in time. Some others change in time, for example the blur one that increases. In case you want to add or edit the effect properties in time, simply click on keyframes and go to effect section. What about the text clips? These are ruled differently. You don't have enhancements or power tools here, but still you can add effects there as well. Let's suppose to have some text. It's important to have this in a video track and not in a title track, placed too much at the bottom. Below the first tracks, you have a special track called Effect Track, indicated through the FX icon. This welcomes just effects from the effect room. Simply choose one and drag it on such track. And this can be edited and ruled just like a normal clip. You can't just move it to another different track. This simply means that all clips above the effect track and under the region occupied by its clips are affected by them. The clips affected can be anything visible, so images, videos and text too. Actually, this is the only way you have to apply these effects to the text. Notice that, in this way, you can apply the same kind of effect to many clips at the same time. To edit the effect clip, simply double-click on it. Let's see now the transitions. There are two kinds of them, the fades and effect transitions. Fades are simply changes of the opacity level, useful when you want to make the clip appear or disappear. These can be added double-clicking on the visible clip and going to fades section. You can add fades between different clips, images or video ones. In this case, simply put closer this and choose crossfade when the list of options appears. If you don't like this, add the transitions. Go to transition room above and choose the one you like. Then simply drag it on the clip. You can add it at the beginning or in the end of it, or between two clips if they are put close enough, or on a crossfade if you want to turn it into a transition. In case you want to edit a transition, simply drag another one on it. If you want to adjust its duration, simply click inside and drag its edges. Click on Modify button above to edit the properties of the applied transition. To remove the transition, you can put the two clips more distant, or you can right-click and go to remove. All this just said is good for image, video and text clips. For audio clips is the same, but instead of crossfades and visual transitions, you have fades in the audio gain level. You can choose between a constant gain level or a constant audio power in output. Thanks for watching! Check our full guide if you missed any video here.